Hey guys, so today we are doing resin. Yay! We are doing a resin project. Finally, I got some new resin in. This is not a sponsored video. I'm going to be using the Dr. Crafty casting and coating epoxy resin kit. I got the smallest one. It's an 8-ounce, 2-part set. And I am going to start using this today, and we'll see how it sets tomorrow. The kit comes with mixing cups, your A and your B resin, and then a few stir sticks, a little leveler, smooth out thing, and instructions, of course. So you always want to be in a well-ventilated area when you use resin. And I am in a storage unit right now, so it's ventilated enough, but here's a little, I like these things. So let's get started and I'll talk you guys through the steps. Okay, first thing we're gonna do is go over the two different ways to mix resin. So these are just the two ways that I know how to mix resin. I kind of know of a third way. The third way would be if you had a big batch, but the two ways that I'm gonna do today are mixing by hand. So some people, I've seen them mix the resin, which this is already the two parts put together. And some people mix resin by putting the two parts together and mixing. And most resin in small batches, you want to mix for 3 minutes. Okay. The other way you can mix what resin is you have your part A and your part B, and you mix them separately for 3 minutes and then put them together and maybe mix for another additional minute. So those are a couple of ways that you can mix, and it's really up to you. It's your preference. It's whatever you have time for. It's also dependent upon the resin that you're using and how much working time you have. This resin gives me a 45 minute working time, so I am fine with mixing these two batches separately and then mixing them together. Just keep in mind when you do mix them separately and then mix them again together, you will have bubbles on top of bubbles. So the best thing to do is to make sure you eliminate the bubbles before you pour the two parts together. So I'm gonna finish my 3 minute mixing and then show you guys the projects that I'm going to attempt today. Okay, so next we are going to, still some bubbles in these, but I think that's okay for right now. I just want to show you guys what colors I'm using. So I have these three colors here, and then my first project, I'm going to use just a dab of this black. I guess it's like a graphite black. So it's like gray and shiny. Does come out pretty dark, but you guys can see how dark that is. And so I'm gonna use that along with the, I guess this is a white color. And a white pigment, like a shiny white. Because I wanna do like this marbling effect. And we're gonna be doing these Geode, I don't know how to say it, whatever. these Geode things. So should get a little good amount of veining, good amount of contrast. So we're gonna do, I guess, these thick ones, these two thick ones. It could probably be the best. So let's start with this, and we're going to start with our darker color first, just to give it a little color. And one thing I don't know is if you're supposed to get the bubbles out before you add color, but I didn't. I don't know if it matters, but I'm just gonna try and get some of these bubbles out as I go. And then some of this in. So I'm gonna make it like a, just like a kind of space. Just a space little looking thing. So I'm just alternating the colors, trying to mix them a little, but not mix them too much. Popping bubbles, popping them bubbles. Pop, pop, pop. Chicka, pop, 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 pop. Demolding our coasters that we made, and then we're going to add some Mica powder. No, not Mica powder. We continue with our coaster molds, and we're gonna paint the edges today with this Gilding paint that I got from Michael. Let me see, it's out of focus. I'll put the name in the bottom, but it's from Craftsmart. It's premium gilding paint, classic gold. So you're gonna need a small brush for details. But first, let's demold this guy right here. I guess I'm doing my own sound effects. Okay, so this was the one that I was trying to marble. I think it had a little too much black in it, but I like it. I think it looks good. That's that one. Then we have this one. It's kind of oceany look with the hole in the middle. So I'm gonna demold this one. And I don't know, I kinda like that. It's very, I like it. Then we're gonna, this one's kinda little, it had more clear, I think, in it. So it's kind of like see-through, which is kinda cool. Like translucent see-through situation, but yeah, I like it. Okay, so what I like about the gilding paint is you put the gilding paint on the edge and you just paint all the way around the edge. You don't need that much. A little goes a long way. So, open this bad boy up. Just take our brush, dab it off, and then just nice even strokes. And this brush I got from the dollar store, it came in like a pack of 7. So, you really don't need, there's no like special brush you need, just one that's small enough and wide enough to cover the edge. You just go all the way around the edge of this and let it dry, and you're pretty much done. And I think the gold, I like seeing the coasters with the gold edge because it makes it look a little more elevated look. A little more elegant, a little more expensive. So this is like the perfect thing that you can add. And a little goes a long way. Like, I'm not gonna go through this. I'm not even gonna go through like a quarter of this bottle doing this on these 3 coasters. So, you know, this one thing of paint will last you a while. I think it was like $9.99, so it's gonna last you a while. And if you're making a lot of coasters, it's a good investment to just add a little, this tiny touch of detail. Sorry, there's a siren behind me. But adding this little touch of detail really makes it look a little more elegant and a little more sophisticated. When people see this on your coffee table, they're gonna be like, ew, that's expensive. And it's really not. So, that's what we're trying to do, make it having fun affordable. So when you're entertaining at home, people are gonna see these coasters and be like, what? You bought that? That's expensive. It's like, nah, I made that. I don't know how long it takes to dry. I would just leave it out to dry. Probably for a few hours. So I think the gilding paint turned out pretty good. Of course, there's a little runny area, but if you can see that, you can see how awesome it looks to have the gilding paint on there. It really does change the way your coasters look. So if you're using the guess it's Geode, I don't know. If you're using that style, that the shape, this like rocky round shape, I highly suggest Gilding paint for accenting. You can use regular gold paint, but I just think the metallic look of this is way different than using gold paint. So yeah, that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoy, and I will catch you next time. I just wanted to pop in and do kind of like a overall final review of the Dr. Crafty Resin. It is one of those resins that does take 72 hours to cure, so keep that in mind when you are using the Dr. Crafty Resin. I'm not a person that reads labels, so I did not know that until after I tried to take it out of the mold. But the good thing is I didn't completely take it out. I just kind of like tested a corner of it, and that obviously was not ready, so I went ahead and waited the whole 72 hours. So just keep that in mind when you are using resin. Don't treat all resin the same. Some of them cure faster than others, and also depending on your weather conditions and where the resin is curing, that also plays a factor. The resin is self-leveling, so I didn't have any leveling problems as long as I was working on a level surface. I used a torch to eliminate any bubbles. You didn't say that you had to use a specific method for eliminating bubbles, but I used a torch because I didn't have access to an outlet for my heat gun, so I had to use a torch, which does not require electricity. The other point I would say is that they did come with some very good accessories. So they had the little yellow scraper, they had the mixing cups already with the measurements on it, so I thought that was really awesome that the kit came with all of that, because some resins don't come with those things. And I guess my final tip would just be to, you know, make sure you read the instructions, follow the instructions on the label of the resin that you're using. So I do highly recommend Dr. Crafty Resin. I am not getting paid. I don't have any affiliates with them. I'm just kind of giving you guys this information so you can have better resin projects. So I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for tuning in.